Thank you so much, Srinivas sir. Your passion really excites us. So I'll continue. I would like to invite Ms. Suniti Nanda, Fintech Officer, Government of Maharashtra, to take this forward.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Great. All right. What a great start. And thank you, NASSCOM, for such a great event. And thank you, Srinivas, sir, to really take out time and come here. He covered everything, and that's exactly why we are here. And he has mentioned anything and everything about what we are going to do. So I joined in this particular role a couple of months back. Few people still ask me, what make you really leave the corporate world? Like, I was in the corporate world last 17 years. And I met Srinivas sir in one of the events. And after meeting him, whatever you heard today, it took me just few minutes to really think that, okay, if I join in this role, what I'm actually committing into is real action. People think that, like, in government, things don't move. People think that it's just policies people talk about. But friends, the reality is there is a lot happening, and there is a lot of enthusiasm and commitment that is there, which will make us implement the policy in the right way and promote the fintech sector towards greater heights. So as sir had mentioned, I'll not get into what all things are there in the policy in the day we'll actually interact more. While all good things are happening, while the fintech sector is actually helping financial services to disrupt itself, and while in this journey, we are cognizant enough to understand that there are a lot of issues this fintech sector is facing. So in this journey, our main focus will be to give the right conducive environment to this sector so that they can actually work and really survive. So having said that, the ecosystem is the one which will create that for this sector. So when I'm saying ecosystem, of course it is not only government, of course it is not only startup, it is each and every one of you who is sitting in this room and beyond are needed, and we all need to join hands to make it happen. So in this process, today whatever you are seeing here, we are actually announcing an accelerator program, and the accelerator program, which is a very unique one. This is one program where you will see, like, you know, multiple partners from the industry will join hands to handpick some of the good solutions across, and we'll be like working with them, and we'll give whatever is needed to make them success and ensure that those products have been adopted in the market. So for this program, we have actually we're gonna partner with Abhishek. Are you there? So we are going to partner with the Fintech Yatra team. I'm not sure how many of you would have heard of. You would have heard of a person named Abhishan Pant, the cashless man. And he's the one who actually went in a journey few months back. And the event that sir was mentioning in the month of June, Honorable Chief Minister actually flagged off the journey. And that's the journey that he actually took on to really go and meet the fintechs on ground. And that's the part of the primary research. So today we actually are glad enough to announced that as a part of the accelerator program, we will be working with the Fintech Yatra team as the execution partner, and we'll be, like, you know, starting on this unique journey starting today, and it's actually the culmination of the great Yatra that he actually started with. So Abhishan, if I can really call up on stage, please. So Abhishan, if you can just, like, you know, take a minute or two, just talk about it, and then.
Thanks, Suniti. Thanks a lot. So around on 2nd of June, I started this journey with the idea that these fintech ecosystem or startup ecosystem was very, very centralized. Everyone needs to come to Bombay to connect with banks, financial institution, and everyone else. And then the idea was this, yaar, sab log Bombay kyun aaye? And during one of the discussion with a startup in Kochi, when we were discussing with them, they said, the consideration that we have is this, कि बॉम्बे आने जाने का खर्चा इज 15,000 रुपया एंड इफ बॉम्बे आने जाने का खर्चा इज 15,000 रुपया वी नीड टू टेक इट कंसिडरेशन दैट शुड वी कम टू बॉम्बे एंड पिच आउट हियर और शुड वी ट्राई टू टेक दैट 15,000 रुपया टू पे फॉर आर 1 month ऑफिस रेंट सो इफ दीज आर दी कंसिडरेशंस डू वी डू इनफ जस्टिस विद स्टार्टअप्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ आस्किंग एवरीवन टू come to a centralized place and then in the world of blockchain where it everything possibly will be decentralized, is it right thing to do? With that being the idea on 2nd of June with support from Srinivas sir and with the chief minister, we flagged off a journey wherein we covered 10,000 kilometers of country. In 75 days, we met with 300 plus startups one-on-one. We did 300 hours of one-on-one conversations. We met with startups in payments, lending, blockchain, and so forth, and possibly did the biggest grounds of research in India from a fintech ecosystem point of view. Once we were concluding the journey at that point of time with the conversation with Srinivas sir and Suniti, we came to a point that the journey will have even more fruit if we can bring those startups, the unique ones that we met across India, and if we can bring them to be catalyzed with partnership with government of Maharashtra and let them be the part of Mumbai Fintech Hub without they having to go through the circus of a hackathon and things of that nature. I'm sounding a bit critical, but without they having to go through that circus, can we bring some of the unique ones to Bombay? So with that being the orientation and intention, today the process gets announced, which is we'll be bringing some of the unique startups to Bombay, and the Mumbai Fintech Accelerator will get started with it. Now, all of this journey was not possible without having the right stakeholders in place, and this accelerator will be unlike anyone you can think of in India or across the world as well, because we'll bring not as an individual entity-led accelerator, but it will be an industry platform-led accelerator wherein there will be NPCI. I'll request Kunal to join. NPCI is the key stakeholder from an ecosystem point of view, and they are largely media shy. So NPCI is the principal partner and the catalyst from an ecosystem point of view. In this accelerator, we will have NPCI is there as a principal partner. We'll have a bank. We'll have one NBFC, one life insurance company, one general insurance company, one blockchain entity, one entity on wealth management side, one entity on financial inclusion side. Largely SIDBI will be there, and all of them put together contributing to creation of an ecosystem which will not would have been thought of, rather than it being looking like an individual entity led accelerators which have not done consistently well over the period of last 3 years. We would like to make it as an industry and ecosystem initiative, and who is a better bigger driver of ecosystem than NPCI?
Thank you, Abhishan. I think thanks to Srinivas sir, the government of Maharashtra. For us, it's a very natural thing. I think our stated goal is that, you know, we have to touch every Indian with a digital transaction. We've done some bits of it, but our belief very, very clearly is I think the next level of acceleration to reach out to every Indian will not happen without the startups. So I think we'll have to work along with them to find use cases, solutions which reach out to every Indian. And if that's our stated vision, so you know, it's a compulsion for us to participate. So we are with you.
So, मैं इस पे कई बार I repeat this at n number of times. So दोबारा से वो कहता हूँ, दोबारा से उस direction में जाता हूँ कि एक बहुत पहले सन 1954 वगैरह में कविता लिखी थी रामधारी सिंह दिनकर ने, जो कुछ इस तरीके से जाती है कि सिर्फ हंगामा खड़ा करना मेरा मकसद नहीं, सारी कोशिश है कि ये सूरत बदलनी चाहिए. मेरे सीने में ना सही, तेरे सीने में सही, हो कहीं भी आग, लेकिन आग जलनी चाहिए. तो हम इन स्टार्टअप्स को जब यहाँ लाएंगे इस शहर में, हम कुछ आग जलाएंगे, और हो सकता है उस आग की तपन में शायद हम कुछ और कैटलाइज कर पाएं.
What a nice kavita. That's really is the crux of it. It's not just about like, you know, sitting quiet. This is the time to really join hands and make things happen and aim for bigger. We need to really dream big. And I'm really looking forward to this program where the way NPCI has got onboarded as the principal partner, we are gonna like onboard many more key partners here. So to mark this occasion, I actually wanted to invite Srinivas sir on stage so that we can actually do MOU exchange just to like start this journey. So please. So with that, thank you so much. This day is going to be really interesting, and I'm going to look forward to really interact with many of you. There are many to talk, many to discuss, and really open for feedback. And there is no like, you know, single formula to make it happen. So really looking forward to hear from you and interact with you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Suniti. So we have a very special session here. So we have worked on a report along with KPMG. The title of the report is Fintech in India Powering a Digital Economy. So we are going to have a report launch for this, and I'm going to invite some dignitaries on stage. First of all, let me invite co-founder of NASSCOM, Harish Mehta sir, on stage.